packing through
Japan. We expected rain early this morning, so when we heard soft taps on our tarp, we woke up with a scare and quickly stuck our heads outside to confirm the raindrops, only to see a whole family of Japanese macaques crossing over us in the canopy above, shaking loose some leaves from the trees.
Awesome sauce.
We started walking towards our Airbnb room and left our backpacks there.
Okay, these are sweet waffles. Super weird.
Since our backpacks are around 20 kilograms each, it's quite bothersome to walk around in town with them. And since we could leave them in our room now, it was a nice opportunity to stroll around a bit, exploring the neighborhood. Two days later, we visited a temple market with lots of different stalls, from plants to clothing to souvenirs, and of course with delicious food stalls. After exploring the temple grounds, we continued to a large Aeon shopping mall.
Okay, so we found an omurice vendor. So I have mito omurice, shiro omurice, which is a Kyoto specialty, and normal traditional omurice. Itadakimasu.
Way bigger than what's on the order map. Famisu!
Free umbrellas to take you to the other side.
The next morning, we left our room and visited the nearby Kyoto Imperial Park. In the Imperial Park, there is a piece of metal picture at every information point, so that one can rub pencil over each part and get a full picture at the end. We also collected all the pieces, so look away for a second if you want to discover the picture for yourself. Okay, you can look again. After we explored the place, we took the train to our next Airbnb room and dug into some food. We found an abandoned empty suitcase lying next to the road while it was raining, so we took it with us and cleaned it up so we could bring some souvenirs home with us. We spent the following days exploring other parts of Kyoto, such as local temples and a few big malls. We also bought some cool souvenirs at a second-hand store. Click the link to see our tidbits video on our haul there. And we enjoyed more of the off-price bento one might find at the day's end in Japanese grocery stores. When the weather was looking up, we explored a part of Kyoto that is famous for its bamboo forest, as well as monkey park and many temples and shrines. We first strolled along the Katsura River and crossed the bridge towards the temples on the foot of the mountain. Since we already saw the Japanese macaques, we felt no need to visit the monkey park. Instead, we wandered through many steps and pathways before returning to the bridge and heading towards the bamboo forest. When we arrived at the bamboo grove, I was struck by the neat and cultivated look of the forest. Since we have slept in a number of bamboo forests by now, I expected to see more dead bamboo, spiderwebs, and general plant matter. However, most of the bamboo stalks were tall and straight, and the road through the bamboo grove was kept clean and tidy. On our way back, the ice cream was not keen at getting caught, but I ate it anyway. We walked back home and enjoyed some snacks.
Okay, in the oven they go. Yum. Let's try some.
Itadakimasu. I think we did something wrong. The next day we visited a roller slide down a hill. See our tidbits video to find out more. After packing our souvenir suitcase as well as our backpacks, we took the train to Osaka for our very last Airbnb in Japan. Please watch our next video to find out more about our stay in Osaka. Mata ni! To follow our adventure, please subscribe. For more details and photos, please visit our website. Want to help us? Please support us on Patreon.